Sources telling CNN Rudy Giuliani's media blitz has blindsided the rest of the president's legal team. Not only did he reveal that the president reimbursed Michael Cohen for the Stormy Daniels hush money payment, he also changed the White House story on why James Comey was fired as FBI director. So, what does this all mean for the Mueller investigation? What does this mean for the White House? Let's discuss. Jack Quinn is here, who is a White House counsel to President Clinton. Laura Coates, CNN legal analyst and former federal prosecutor. And Philip Lacovera, who is counsel to the Watergate special prosecutors. Good evening. Welcome to the program. Glad to have you all here. Mm-hmm. Laura, this is now the third justification that we have heard for James Comey's firing. First, the president said that Comey was fired over his handling of the Clinton email investigation, pointing to a letter justifying that it was written by Rod Rosenstein. Then, the president said this in his interview with Lester Holt.
Regardless of recommendation, I was going to fire Comey, knowing there was no good time to do it. And in fact, when I decided to just do it, I said to myself, I said, you know, this Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story.
And then last night, Giuliani weighed in.
He fired Comey because Comey would not, among other things, say that he wasn't a target of the investigation. He's entitled to that. Hillary Clinton got that. And he couldn't get that. So he fired him, and he said, I'm free of this guy.
Hmm. So why the shifting rationale on Comey's firing, and why can't they get their story straight, Laura?
Well, it seems as though they're always trying to figure out how they can make themselves be presented in the best light. But what they're doing with all the different variations of these stories, all the different iterations and discussions and explanations slash confessions, all they do is the equivalent of saying, Don, do not think of a pink elephant. Now, all you can think of is a pink elephant. If you're Robert Mueller's team wondering why James Comey was fired, and they keep telling you all the different explanations, well, guess what? You have brought a magnifying glass on the very top of their heads to say, is there a reason you can't get your story straight? And normally it's because a lie just sounds like a lie. The truth sounds like truth. And when you have variations of it, it's a problem. Also, you have the shift of different legal teams and everyone trying to have a legal strategy that matches with the court of public opinion and PR campaign. And when that is your focus, the PR campaign of court of public opinion, you often make missteps that you would not make in a court of law. Mm-hmm. That's what you're seeing here.
And Cohen said he had not been reimbursed. But Laura, listen, Giuliani's explanation also contradicts the president himself, who has said that Comey told him on three separate occasions that he was not under investigation. Comey has even confirmed, he's confirmed that. Mm-hmm. So this not under investigation is somehow different than not being a target of the investigation?
Well, it is. I mean, semantics is more than the issue here. If you're a target, it means that there is likely evidence that could link you to a crime. If you're the subject, it means that your conduct is under the scrutiny or in relation to the grand jury's overall investigation. The two is distinct, but it's very fascinating to me, Don, that Rudy Giuliani would be asking for Donald Trump to get the Hillary Clinton treatment. Remember, one of the things that the Hillary treatment included was that if you were to alert the public about an ongoing investigation or that they were a target, then you had the triggering obligation to then tell the court or the Congress or the American people that they are no longer a target, or if that changes again back to that. But the president's lawyer asking for that particular, you know, allowance to say, I'd like the Hillary Clinton treatment, would actually say that if there was to be a change between that very thin line between a subject and a target, that we should all be alerted every single time, which is not at all what Donald Trump was asking for when he allegedly asked statements about loyalty. It's not at all what he would want. It's not at all what a reasonable person would want to do, to have that constant clarification, validation, or confirmation that they are in the eye of the Mueller investigation.
All right, I want all of you to stick around. When we come back, why did Rudy Giuliani reveal that the president repaid Michael Cohen? Was it part of a strategy, or was it a slip-up? More questions tonight about Rudy Giuliani's stunning admission that the president was aware of the payments to the porn star Stormy Daniels. Was that revelation part of a new legal strategy? Back with me now, Jack Quinn, Laura Coates, and Philip Lacovera. Okay, so Laura, you know, we've repeatedly heard from the White House that President Trump had no knowledge of the payments to Stormy Daniels. Take a listen to this.
There was no knowledge of any payments from the president, and he's denied all of these allegations.
The president strongly clearly and has consistently denied these underlying claims.
The president has denied the allegations. We've spoken about this issue extensively, and I don't have anything else to add.
You know about the payments to Stormy Daniels.
So do you think there is a legal strategy behind Giuliani revealing that the president did repay Michael Cohen?
Only if stupid is a litigation strategy. If not, then no, there was no strategy behind it, because what he did was give more exposure to the president of the United States. Remember, Don, if this was a loan, it's still an excessive campaign contribution that needed to be reported to the Federal Election Commission. That the president would have repaid the loan, that would also be part of the reporting requirements. If this was not part of the reporting requirements, why would there ever be campaign finance laws? All you'd have to do if you were a member of a campaign is say, give me a loan, I'll pay it back after the end of the election. No one has to be any wiser about this, and we'll circumvent everything. They still had reporting requirements, and Rudy Giuliani's comment that this money was funneled, that's the word he used, funneled through a law firm, indicates that maybe it was willful and intentional, which now sounds like more like a criminal violation than simply an FEC issue.
He maintained in that interview and maintains all along that it's not a campaign violation. I think this will help everyone make the point, because Rudy Giuliani told the Washington Post that he paid Cohen with his personal funds because they never considered this a campaign payment. But he also said this. Watch this.
Imagine if that came out on October 15th, 2016, sure. In the middle of the last debate with Hillary Clinton.
So to make it go away, they made this
Cohen
payment.
Didn't even ask. Cohen made it go away. He did his job.
Okay.
Case closed.
So to make it go away, campaign was going to be impacted, we decided to help the campaign by giving a $130,000 benefit. That's called a contribution. That's called one that you make to donate to a campaign. That statement, even if he had the discombobulation that you're speaking of last night, between last night and this morning, you made the case even stronger by talking about it being a campaign issue.
And remember, the alleged affair took place 10 years before that. So 6 weeks before an election, they have this felt need to take care of a 10-year-old affair. It's just not plausible.
So have Rudy Giuliani's comments made things worse for Michael Cohen? Do they matter?
Oh, absolutely.
How so?
Yeah, I think they do, because he basically said that what Cohen was doing was arranging for a fix of the political problems that the president was having during the election. And one of the things that struck me, and I think it was probably a Freudian slip from Rudy, who made his bones as a racket buster in the U.S. Attorney's office, even before he was the U.S. attorney, he used the term describing Michael Cohen's job, which was to find a problem and make the problem disappear. Exactly the kind of language that I'm sure Rudy used in any number of racketeering prosecutions when he was describing the way the mob eliminated problems that were had to be made to disappear. I can't think that there was any good impact from Rudy's comments last night in advancing his client's cause.
Great conversation. Go ahead, quick, if you can do it.
I was going to say, the only thing I can think he was trying, if I want to throw him a lifeline, I think he was trying to say that the payment was coincidental and that he would have gotten his retainer anyway. Right. Now, that fails, of course, because he then said that it was made for services not rendered and given profit and tax benefit as well. So even when his attempt to say this was a coincidental, benign transaction was undermined by Rudy's following statement. It's a mess.
I would not want you as my prosecutor. You know way too much, Lauren.
So does Mueller. Apparently.
Can we get another prosecutor? He's too smart. Batting down every argument. Thank you. I appreciate
it. Thank you all.
And we come back, from America's mayor to Trump's top defender, how Rudy Giuliani has changed over the years. I'm going to talk to someone who knew him well, or knows him well, next.